गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। आई एम डॉक्टर संजय गौरी, हेड एंड असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजिक्स, डॉक्टर अंबेडकर कॉलेज, चंद्रपुर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर ए लेक्चर ऑन ऑपरेशनल एम्पलीफायर। सो दिस टॉपिक इज द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम द एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू। सो मेनी टाइम द क्वेश्चन हैज बीन आस्क्ड ऑन दिस ऑपरेशनल एम्पलीफायर। सो टुडे माय प्रेजेंटेशन इंक्लूड्स what is meant by the difference amplifier that we have already seen, and this difference amplifier is nothing but the basic building block of the operational amplifier. Then after that we will define the differential mode gain of the amplifier, then common mode gain of the amplifier. Later on we will study the definition of the common mode rejection ratio. This definition is very important from the examination point of view. Then we will study the construction and working of operational amplifier, and lastly I will discuss about the electrical symbol of the operational amplifier. So first of all we see the difference amplifier that we have already seen. So this difference amplifier has two input and the two outputs, and the circuit of this difference amplifier is shown in this diagram, in this slide. So here there are the two inputs, input IP1 and input IP2. These are the two inputs of the difference amplifier, and there are the two outputs. One output is the OP1 and another output is OP2. These are the two outputs of the difference amplifier. And here the input between the base and the common ground is nothing but the one input, and another input is the IP2 and the common ground. So this both these inputs are called the single ended inputs, and the single ended output is taken at the point A, and the single ended output is also taken at the point B. So out of this A and common ground and B and common ground, this is the single ended outputs, single ended output. There is a double ended output, and that output is taken in between the point A and point B. So at the output terminal, A and at the output terminal B, if we take the outputs, then we get a double ended output. Okay, so this is about the difference amplifier. Then what is meant by the differential mode gain? The voltage gain of a difference amplifier is called the differential mode gain, and it is generally denoted as A of D. Thus, the differential mode gain is the ratio of differential mode input is the ratio of output to the differential mode input. So here A of D is the mod of A of D. A is for gain and D is for the difference. So differential mode gain of the amplifier is the ratio of output to the differential mode input, and this is for the single ended output. Okay. So this is the definition of the differential mode gain. Here the output divided by differential mode input, and that is nothing but the differential mode gain. Then we will study the common mode gain. So if suppose V1 and V2 both are equal, then output expected to be zero in the difference amplifier. When both inputs are the similar, both inputs which are applied at the input terminal IP1 and at the input terminal IP2, both inputs are the same, and they are V1 equal to V2, then the output of the difference amplifier is expected to be 0. But in practice, we certainly get some output even when V1 is equal to V2. The gain of the amplifier under such condition is called the common mode gain. What we call the common mode gain? So, the gain of the amplifier under such condition, which condition? V1 is equal to input. Inputs are the similar. Then, the gain of the amplifier under such condition is called the common mode gain, and it is denoted by A of C, C for common mode and A for gain. So, common mode gain of the single-ended output of the amplifier is given by A of C is equal to output upon common mode input. Previously, we have taken for differential mode gain output upon differential mode input. And here, for the common mode gain, the output upon common mode input. And it is equal to HFE RL upon RS plus HIE plus 2 times HFE RE. Here RS is the source resistance, HIE is the input impedance of the amplifier, then RE is the emitter resistor, RL is the load resistance, and HFE is the forward current gain. So for good difference amplifier, the common mode gain should be as small as possible. It is a zero for the ideal amplifier. It is zero for the ideal amplifier. Then we will see the definition of the common mode rejection ratio. It is called CMRR. If an amplifier possesses a capacity to reject a common mode signal, if an amplifier possesses a capacity of to reject a common mode signal को reject करने की जो capacity है, that is judged in terms of the figure of merit or quality of the difference amplifier. So the quality of or figure of merit of a difference amplifier is judged from its common mode rejection ratio, that is the CMRR, and it is the ratio of differential mode gain to the common mode gain. CMRR, it is the differential mode gain upon common mode gain. If the two inputs of the difference amplifier are V1 and V2, then the output of the difference amplifier is V1 difference V2, and on the average input. Thus, the output of the difference amplifier is given by V0 or VO is equal to A of D in bracket V1 minus V2 plus 1 upon CMRR into V1 plus V2 upon 2. So, this is nothing but average of the input, and this is the differential mode gain multiplied by difference in the input. Difference in the input, and that input is the double ended. So after this, we will study the operational amplifier. What is meant by the operational amplifier? From the name itself, it is clear that it will do the some operations. Which are the operations? The operation is nothing but addition, subtraction, then multiplication. These are the operations which can be done by the integration. This is also the operation done by the operational amplifier, and therefore it is called the operational amplifier. The difference amplifier is the basic building block of the operational amplifier. The operational amplifier is a high gain amplifier. And this operational amplifier, block diagram of this operational amplifier is shown in this slide. So operational amplifier consists of four cascaded stages. Cascaded stages means four stages. They are connected to each other. And this is nothing but the operational amplifier. So thus, an IC operational amplifier consists of four cascaded stages. So which are the four cascaded stages? First stage is the difference amplifier. Second stage is also the difference amplifier number two. Third stage is the emitter follower. And fourth stage is the level shifter output stage. So these are the four stages of the operational amplifier. And they are cascaded together. They are connected together. And here the inputs are given to the two inputs of the difference amplifier number one. And this input is nothing but the double ended input. So the output, the first stage is the difference amplifier with double ended output. Here are the double ended output. This is the one output terminal OP1. And this is the output terminal OP2 of the first difference amplifier. And these two output terminals OP1 and OP2 of the first difference amplifier is given to the input of the second difference amplifier number 2. Okay, OP1 is given to the input terminal IP1. OP2 is given to the input terminal IP2. And the output of the second difference amplifier is taken as this single-ended. It is taken as single-ended. Single-ended means the output of the difference amplifier is taken, output of the second difference amplifier is taken at the output terminal A or B and common ground. This is the common ground. So this is nothing but OP1 or OP2. Out of these two, you can take output, any one of the output. Then the third stage of the operational amplifier is the emitter follower. Third stage is the emitter follower. So third stage of the operational amplifier is the emitter follower. Means gain of this emitter follower is the unity. Emitter follower is an amplifier which has the very high input impedance and a low output impedance. This emitter follower has high input impedance so that it should draw the less current, and it has low output impedance. The gain of the emitter follower is almost unity, and this stage therefore acts as a buffer between the second stage and the fourth stage. It is the buffer between, it is the mediator between the two stages, second stage and the fourth stage of the operational amplifier, and thus avoids the unavoidable loading. Loading effect is avoided if it is present. If it is not present, then loading of the amplifier will take place. And that loading of the amplifier will reduce the voltage gain. Thus, the emitter follower does not contribute to the overall voltage gain. Kya ho raha hai? Jo emitter follower ye voltage gain ko bada nahi raha hai. पहला स्टेज है डिफरेंस एम्पलीफायर, ये काय के लिए, इट इज अ हाई गेन एम्पलीफायर, एंड द सेकंड स्टेज इज आल्सो द डिफरेंस एम्पलीफायर व्हिच इज आल्सो द हाई गेन एम्पलीफायर. व्हेन दीज टू स्टेजेस आर कंबाइंड टुगेदर, देन एट द आउटपुट ऑफ द सेकंड डिफरेंस एम्पलीफायर वी गेट अ वेरी हाई आउटपुट. मींस गेन ऑफ द एम्पलीफायर, सेकंड एम्पलीफायर विल बी द वेरी हाई. And if we if we not using the emitter follower circuit here, this gain of the secondary difference amplifier will be reduced. And here, in order to avoid the loading effect, this is nothing but gain of the second amplifier is reduced. Its meaning is that this second difference amplifier is loaded. And for that, in order to avoid the loading effect of the second difference amplifier, we use the emitter follower circuit. And fourth block of the operational amplifier is the level shifter output stage. The last stage helps to bring out the output to 0 volt level. Last stage is only for obtaining the 0 output level when the inputs are grounded, that is to the ground potential. In the absence of any input, यदि कोई इनपुट अपन ने अप्लाई नहीं किया ऑपरेशनल एम्पलीफायर को, तो आउटपुट ऑफ दिस लेवल शिफ्टर शुड बी जीरो, बट इन प्रैक्टिस इट इज नॉट जीरो. एंड देयरफॉर इन ऑर्डर टू ऑब्टेन द आउटपुट ऑफ द लेवल शिफ्टर टू बी जीरो, व्हाट वी डू, इवन इफ वी डू नॉट अप्लाई द इनपुट टू द ऑपरेशनल एम्पलीफायर, द आउटपुट विल बी देयर विल बी द सम आउटपुट. एंड इन ऑर्डर टू रिड्यूस दिस आउटपुट टू द 0 volt level, there is a level shifter stage in the operational amplifier. And this level shifter stage will reduce the collector potential at either of the collector of the second difference amplifier would be high and positive with respect to the common ground. But for DC amplifier, it is essential that in the absence of a signal, the output should be at 0 volt level. But output, we do not get the output to be at a 0 volt level. In order to bring that output to be at 0 volt level, there is a level shifter. So the circuit of this level shifter is shown in this slide, and this is the simple circuit of the level shifter, that one transistor is there, Q1, another transistor is there, Q2, input is applied at this terminal and the output is taken at the Y terminal. And the second input, the input of the second transistor Q2 is grounded, and these are the biasing resistors, and this will help to reduce the output of the operational amplifier to be zero when the both inputs are not applied. So potential at X is at higher and positive, and the transistor Q2 functions as a constant current source. So this second transistor will work as a constant current source. It will supply the constant current to this terminal. Thus, potential at the point, the transistor Q2 functions as a constant current source, so that the current I flowing through the resistor R is a constant, and thus the potential at the point Y should be V of Y is equal to V of X minus 0.6 minus IR, and the 0.6 is being the potential drop in the base emitter junction of Q1, and thus it can be seen that the proper selection of the current I and the resistor R, it is possible to bring out the potential at Y to be at the desired level. And this is the circuit of the level shifter of the operational amplifier, fourth stage of the operational amplifier. And lastly, the electrical symbol of the operational amplifier. This is nothing but the electrical symbol of the operational amplifier. And that you are using in the practical. So in the electrical symbol of the operational amplifier, a triangle is there and one input is plus, another input is minus. This plus input is called the non-inverting input, and minus terminal is called the inverting input. And there is a only one output. There is a only one output. Here first non-inverting input plus sign is for the non-inverting input, minus sign is for the inverting input, and the output is the Y. And this output is taken here. And there are the two power supplies used in the operational amplifier. One power supply is the plus VCC and another power supply is the minus VCC. These two power supplies are used, and therefore they are shown like this. And there is no need of this remaining circuit. ये जो circuit है इसकी जरूरत नहीं है, लगाए तभी चलता है, नहीं लगाए तभी चलता है. Okay, so this plus terminal is nothing but the non-inverting input. Non-inverting input. It means that if we apply the input signal here, input signal यदि ऐसे apply करते हैं, AC cycle अपन apply करने वाले positive cycle as well as negative cycle. This is the positive half cycle and this is the negative half cycle of the input signal. When positive half cycle is applied, then output will also be the in the same phase. ऐसे ही आउटपुट अपने को मिलने वाला है. पॉजिटिव साइकिल इधर आएगा इनपुट सिग्नल का, तो आउटपुट सिग्नल का भी पॉजिटिव साइकिल आएगा. नेगेटिव हाफ साइकिल आएगा इनपुट सिग्नल का, तो आउटपुट का भी नेगेटिव सिग्नल आएगा. नेगेटिव हाफ सिग्नल आए हाफ साइकिल आएगा. मीन्स दीज टू वेव्स आर इन फेज एंड देयरफॉर इट इज कॉल्ड द नॉन इन्वर्टिंग. यदि अपन यहाँ पे इन्वर्टिंग इनपुट को इनपुट अप्लाई करते हैं, इनपुट कैसे अप्लाई करेंगे? इनपुट ये इसी प्रकार से एसी सिग्नल इज अप्लाइड लाइक दिस. ये इस टाइप का एसी सिग्नल अपन जब अप्लाई करेंगे तो ओके, तो ड्यूरिंग द पॉजिटिव हाफ साइकिल द आउटपुट विल बी एग्जैक्टली रिवर्स. ये पॉजिटिव साइकिल इधर आएगा तो आउटपुट में आएगा नेगेटिव साइकिल. मींस लाइक दिस. देन जब नेगेटिव साइकिल आएगा, नेगेटिव हाफ साइकिल आएगा इनपुट सिग्नल का, तो यहां पे आउटपुट में अपने को मिलेगा पॉजिटिव साइकिल लाइक दिस. सो दिस मींस दीज टू वेव्स इनपुट सिग्नल एंड आउटपुट सिग्नल आर आउट ऑफ फेज एंड देयरफॉर such input terminal is known as the inverting input because it will invert the output. Positive cycle input signal ka aayega to output mein negative half cycle aayega, aur input ka yadi negative half cycle aayega to output mein positive half cycle aayega, and therefore it is called that negative terminal is called the inverting input. These two views are out of phase. So this is about all about the operational amplifier, construction and working of the operational amplifier and the output electrical symbol of the operational amplifier. This is all about my today's presentation. If you have any question, you can ask me. Otherwise, I will end my this meeting.